For yet another year, may the 4th be with you. Time to talk about another Star Wars movie. The Phantom Menace may not be the Star Wars prequel that fans hoped for, but it was a financial hit, grossing almost $1 billion worldwide. This made it impossible to deny that the prequel trilogy was able to keep going. 3 years later, we got Episode 2, Attack of the Clones. With that film's release, audiences were divided on whether or not to prefer this film over Phantom Menace. The argument can be viewed both ways, so here's my perspective. The film is set 10 years after its predecessor. Now, 19-year-old Anakin Skywalker is training under Obi-Wan Kenobi in the ways of the Jedi. During this period, Senator Padme Amidala, who used to be the Queen of Naboo, is being targeted by a bounty hunter and must be protected by Anakin while Obi-Wan looks for said bounty hunter. If you've watched these movies, you know what else is happening. Anakin and Padme develop a poorly done romance, which goes against the Jedi Code, and Obi-Wan struggles against Count Dooku, a former Jedi Master who turned to the dark side. Might as well speak of the romance scenes. Understandably, this is part of the story, but it slows the movie down and tells us more than we need to know. Part of this being poorly done contributes to the performances of Hayden Christensen and Natalie Portman. They're pretty bland in the characters they play. I don't blame this on Christensen, the script didn't give him much to work with, but some of the dialogue you'd wonder how he was okay with speaking, such as, "I don't like sand. It's coarse and rough and irritating, and it gets everywhere." Nobody thought about this? Nobody thought that maybe this was not a good line? Maybe he was recounting his days as a slave, I don't know. At least he's not saying yippee anymore. Okay, the romance is a major problem and the writing is not very good. The visuals, once again, are a bit dated. I'm not exactly talking on the computer effects, though they do age poorly. It looks cool when you're seeing ships in space. I also like the costume design. But sometimes on the character Jango Fett, you'd swear that some of the time his costume is CG. Or maybe that's just me. Or perhaps it's from all the technology you see in the rest of the movie. Or it's just the way the lighting hits the armor. Whatever the reason, some of those shots just don't look right. Where the characters were not well developed, there were some characters that saw a bit of improvement. Remember Jar Jar Binks from Phantom Menace, how annoying he was? Thankfully, we get less Jar Jar in this movie. But even better, he served a major purpose in setting up the events of the original trilogy. When Obi-Wan goes looking for the bounty hunter on the planet Kamino, he discovers a clone army that was built for the Republic under the name of a deceased Jedi Master. Later on, Jar Jar, who is now a Senate representative, helps in granting authorization for use of the clone army to Chancellor Palpatine, who of course would later use it to build the Galactic Empire with Anakin by his side. That is a huge part of the Star Wars timeline. Guess Jar Jar wasn't so useless after all, even if his actions proved to be fatal to the galaxy. Aside from bad writing, underdeveloped characters, and overly used computer effects, another problem this film carries over from Phantom Menace is how overly complicated the story is. Once again, I don't have any problem with making a more complex story for the Star Wars prequels. Just like Phantom Menace, it's not all that engaging, and you'd have to watch the film over and over again in order to truly get the grasp of what's happening. You have no idea how many times I rewatched these movies before I got a good basic understanding of the plot of the prequel trilogy. It's ridiculous how incoherent these films are. It's not like the prequels are terrible. I still like them, especially Revenge of the Sith, which closed off the prequel trilogy. I think that should have been the last film that got made for the Skywalker saga. But then we got the sequel trilogy, and not only that, Star Wars itself is getting all sorts of spin-offs and side projects. Yeah, Star Wars was great back in the day, but at some point it's gotta stop. Nothing's ever gonna get as good as the classic trilogy. The prequel trilogy tried with it, but the only great one in that trilogy was Revenge of the Sith. But what about Attack of the Clones, the subject of this review? Do I find it better or worse than Phantom Menace? Personally think it's a little better. It's got flaws that are pretty obvious, but I'm cool with it.